In today's episode, we're going to be discussing leaders and why use them and how to make them. I've seen some guys fish without leaders. Since this series is primarily designed for the Northeast fishermen targeting striped bass, bluefish, and weak fish, I would advise you to use a leader. I don't know if there's areas where you fish you can get away without using one, but I cannot see a single reason here. Unless there's very specified situations, why would you not use a leader? Leader in general is made out of three different materials. I've seen guys use them from each. Leader material, fluorocarbon, or this is also a leader material that's made with like a tri-color line, which is what I use. Guys also make leaders with regular mono. You don't need to have a leader material. You do need something that's durable, that's going to be heavy. Why heavy? Well, leaders helps us. They help us in a few ways. First of all, they absorb the shock when you cast the lure. So when you load up your cast, they absorb the shock of the lure. They absorb the shock of fish hitting the lure. They also give you abrasion resistance when this fish is rubbing against the rocks, when the line is rubbing against the fish's gills or the mouth. Now, if that's braided and it's under tension and it's thin, it's gonna snap. So this it has more give, it's thicker, and it has better abrasion resistance. One of the most important reasons why I use a leader is when you handle the fish. You don't want to be grabbing a braid. The braid is so thin, it's going to cut your hands right to the bone. You want to have something thick to grab on where you can control the fish and get it under control so you can get the hooks out of it and not end up in a hook and in your hands. Obviously, if you fish in places like rocks or jetties, it also assists you trying to pull the fish up on the rocks. You might say, well, why not just use mono? Mono is not it's also thicker. Well, because if you're going to use mono for casting, it's probably going to be somewhere between 12 and 17 pounds. At least that's what we used to use in the old days. And if you try to hoist a fish on a rock with a 12-pound mono, a 20-pound bass, well, guess what? There's 12-pound breakage and a 20-pound fish. Something's going to give. And 99 out of 100 times is going to be your mono. So this is why you use heavier mono. Guys will use anywhere between 50 and 100 pounds. Most of the guys will stay between 50 and 80. 100 pounds is sometimes a little hard to tie. Or use a leader material in the 40 to 50 pound range is what I usually use, although I do use lighter stuff for the back base, which is exactly where fluorocarbon comes in. Fluorocarbon is not necessary when you're fishing the open beaches. They're full of sand and, you know, grass and weed and all kinds of stuff keeps churning. We toss the camera in there, we can barely see a lure. So the fish has a hard time enough seeing your lure. I don't think they're gonna worry about seeing your fluorocarbon. But when you're fishing in a back bay area in a still, calm, clear water, the fluorocarbon does make a difference. And also what makes a difference is tying direct in those situations.